This was a pretty straightforward implementation one. We're just kind of slow, based on this bug here. I'm not writing the parentheses, but let's see. Pretty simple problem. You can go clean this up, probably, and actually walk through the entire problem. So, in this problem, it's a bunch of boat races, I guess, and for part one, each one of these represents each of the boat races, and so this is saying that a race lasted for 7 milliseconds, and the record distance was 9. And the mechanics of a race is basically you hold a button to charge up the speed of your boat, and then you let go. So every millisecond you hold it down adds like 1, I guess, millimeter per second to the speed of your boat, and when you let go, it will travel at that speed for the rest of the race. And so the question is asking basically for each race, how many possible ways can you beat the record? So this is pretty straightforward to simulate because the number of ways you can beat the record, it's binary. You hold down basically if the race is T seconds long, you hold it down for N seconds, and then it'll go forward for N minus T seconds, or milliseconds, for the rest of the race. And so the first part of the problem is just parsing the input, so we can do that here. No file input has this like this first line, but it's not really important right now. If I equals 0, then we're parsing time. So we can say time is equal to, or it's equal times, and we can do int x where x in line.split. We'll split on spaces, and we'll omit the first thing that gets split, because we don't care about this like time header basically. Else, distances is going to be the same thing. So that gives us the times of the distance basically. And then we basically just run the simulation. So we'll solve the problem. So we have times and we have distance in the race. And I decided to use zip to like zip these two together, so these will make tuples of like 7, 9, 15, 20, 30, 200. And we'll just rename something better, like number of wins is gonna be equal to 0. Then we just simulate all the wins we can win in the race. Just for the sake of completeness here, since the race is 7 seconds long, technically you can hold it for 0 seconds or 7 milliseconds, but we'll never go anywhere in those races, but we'll simulate them anyways. So for hold time in range up until time plus 1, what do we do? We'll go total distance is going to equal how long we held it for, because that's our speed, times the total time of the race minus the hold time. So the bug that I have was I didn't put the parens, and so order of operations obviously made it so it was hold times time minus hold time, which is very different from what the actual math is. Then we'll do if total distance is greater than the, this is technically the record, so that reads better. Then we'll go number of wins is incremented. So we'll go part one. We'll just do this way. And apparently math has a thing called prod now to do the product of things. So I'll just say part one dot append the number of ways that we could win here. And so we want to multiply them all together. So then we can just say the answer to part one is going to be the product of all of the outcomes here. So this, in theory, should append 4, 8, and 9 on the sample input. Can we just quickly do... Oh, haha, this is still from the previous day. We'll paste this in, and then we'll try to run it. This is day Now for part two, it simplifies it. Basically, rather than these being treated as separate races, 715 and 30, you just are smushing those two things together. So really, a nicer way to write this probably is to write a function called solve that takes in time and distance, or I guess time and record, and then we just take this stuff out, and then we return number of things. So we define this as the main function for actually solving the problem. Then part one here is just going to be the product of solving time record for time record in zipping time and distances together. Like that. We don't even need to do the appending to this list or anything. Hopefully this still works. Looks like it does. And then, so for part two, we just have to basically glue these numbers together. The fastest way for to do this while actually solving the problem is just convert them to strings, join them together, and then reinterpret that as an integer. So part two time is going to be int of joining together string n for n in times. Likewise, part two, let's see. Distance is going to be the same thing, but for distances. And then we could do print the answer to part 2 is equal to solve time and oops. It'll be part 2 time, part 2 distance. Doing that, we should get what the sample says, and we want 503. Run it off real input, let's 06.txt. We get 861300 over here, and we get this number over here. So, I guess technically this takes like a little bit to compute, a little bit of time to compute part 2, because it's a decently big number. If we actually check the puzzle input here, it's gonna be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8 digits long, so not too much to crunch through, but if we give this to PyPy, oh, it's a different version that doesn't have the prod thing. Okay, well in that case, I'll do from utils import mul, which I think calls out the func tools to do it, my utilities, but basically achieves the exact same thing. And this executes really quickly. So yep, pretty straightforward. We seem to be following that same pattern of even days are easy. Jonathan Paulson moved up, Robert Zhao in 5th, pretty cool. Where are we? We moved up into the top 50, we gained a few points. We were 51st for today, now we're up to 49th. Yeah, because I think I was 130th or something for part 1, but then some swift typing for part 2, everyone seemed to finish like very similar times, so we clawed an extra 33 points today. So. Not too bad, could have been faster on part 1. I think, yeah, just a few seconds faster would have put us somewhere in like top in this range if it weren't for that the bracket bug there. So, silly bug, but at least we got some points for day 6. And back to getting some points. So, hopefully, tomorrow.